Don't bring me a glass, bring me the whole bottle of wine, because after this episode of Insecure, my gay ass is going to need it!
I'm the librarian. And I came to read.
Y'all have no idea how happy I am that the show is back the fuck on. It is everything, it is realistic, it is relatable, and I'm about to get my goddamn life every fucking week that this, I'm going to be doing reviews of Tan Hut, bitch. I'm gonna be standing in formation just like Beyonce told me to. Now we start off this episode, we see this scene with Lawrence and Issa, they just sitting across from each other. It's kinda, it looks like they're kinda on a date or some shit. It's like, girl, this is too good to be goddamn true. Bitch, it must be some type of daydream, and it was. And bitch, we cut right into Dustin Ross ass congratulations for you getting on this sickening ass show. But yeah, Dustin Ross ass is like, hey girly, you know, why are you single? She, Philip Hudson, it was a lot of people. You know, shout out to Issa for actually, you know, lending her hand out. She got this platform now, so she's making sure that she's bringing other people up with her, and that's sickening. So it was a cute little scene in the beginning, and the end, she was just, she had a little rap like she always does, the poet, the lyricist that she is, you know what I mean? She had a rap talking about, girl, I'm a cheater, so what's the tea, bitch? The only reason why I'm here is because my nigga won't take me back. And then we move right the fuck along to Molly at therapy. Now, Molly is like me. When a lot of people told me to go to a therapist and shit like that because of a bunch of traumatic shit that happened in my life. So I'm sitting my ass down at the therapist just like Molly, and I'm just like this. Okay, I'm here now, so what's up? You know what I mean? Like, okay, let's talk now since you want to talk, then talk, honey. And the therapist was just like, girl, you know, I noticed that we're talking a lot about your work life and not about anything else. And you know, is there anything outside of work that you want to talk about? And Molly's sitting there just like I was. I'm not sure what you're talking about, girl. That's about it. And then the therapist looked at her like, and then Molly looked back like, bitch, it was a stare off, honey. And the therapist was like, okay, girl, come back when you're ready and open. And that really speaks volumes, and we'll get to the next scene too, which also is very deep, but it speaks volumes about the people like Molly who were reluctant to go to a therapist in the first place. But at least, you know, as long as you keep trying and keep consistent, unlike me, you know, maybe you can see some type of results. Then they had the scene with Molly and Issa Rae there over there in the park and shit. And Molly was talking about her different experiences trying to search for a therapist. I thought that was important too, because when you go out and, you know you need to see a doctor or some shit, you don't just settle on the first doctor you see. You have to, you know, kind of experiment, trial and error. You have to research your doctors. Just like she is kind of doing with her therapist, she's making sure that they can relate to her. It's just making sure that she's also comfortable with them. I like that this show tackles the issues that the black community kind of faces in general, and it has kind of constructive conversations about it. Ugh, Insecure is just so sickening. So Molly was just like, girl, it seems like you want your nigga back. I know you lying, bitch, but niggas always want you back when they see that you're doing good. And then so that, you know, light bulb went off in Issa's head, and just like, And that's when the thought of this party came up. We'll talk about this tragic ass party later on. Let me tell you something, it gave me everlasting joy to come up here in the first scene of Lawrence that I really see is his cheeks clapping. There's just something about clapping cheeks. You hear what I'm saying? As a gay man, when I saw Lawrence cheeks just clapping, bitch, against Tasha, I said, girl, I'm going to lose my shit, because first of all, Lawrence is fine as hell. I don't care what the hell y'all are saying. Tasha got a body for days as well. She's throwing it in a circle, octagon, pentagon. I'm talking about triangle type of teeth. She went to geometry class, bitch, unlike some of these teachers at Issa Rae school. She went to geometry class and she learned how to do them angles, bitch. Bitch, I'm talking about Tasha was throwing that, bitch, bitch, I said, you better, bitch, and Lawrence was just, he just fucking the shit. I said, girl, my gay ass, I'm about to explode, literally. So, girl, I mean, I guess they fucking, Tasha, I guess she wants to be treated more like a girlfriend or whatever the tea is, and it seems like Lawrence is just coming over to fuck her from Friday until Sunday, bitch, and then he just leaves, girl, and Tasha's like, girl, what's the tea? I want something more with you, and Lawrence is like, okay, sis, I'll see you next Friday, girl. Oh, Lawrence ain't shit. And then we see that his ass is still blowing up the air mattress, sweetheart, with his friend. And they were talking about the situation. It's like, girl, I see what you're doing, honey. It's like clockwork. From Friday to Sunday, you do what you got to do, and then you dip. You don't even take her ass out. We then quickly cut to Issa Rae on Tinder, I guess. She's swiping left, girl. She said, ain't no nigga gonna dick me down like Lawrence. And after two times, after we've seen Lawrence dick Tasha down two times, I'm going to agree with Issa. Ain't no bitch, after I get Lawrence dick, I'm not finna be running around here to nobody else. Do you see those strokes? Do you see those strokes? It's disrespectful to me, because at this point, I'm about to call me one of my motherfucking trays. Matter of fact, I might have to go back in time to, you know, when I was fucking drug dealers and shit like that, because that's the type of stroke that I saw on my screen today. Do you see what I'm saying? That's the type of intensity, the hood nigga stroke that he was giving touch. So when I saw Issa in her bed just swiping left, I understand. Because can't no dick do you like Lawrence dick. I understand it. I understand it. So Issa Rae is at this new school trying to present the We Got Y'all program to this. I think it's primarily Latino students. And they were just not biting. They were not feeling that shit. Even when Issa went to the teacher of the class to be like, hey, girl, how can we get them involved into this We Got Y'all program? And she was just like, girl, I'm not really focused on that shit. I'm supposed to be an art teacher. They got me teaching geometry, girl. I have to go ahead and relearn this shit. So y'all can do what y'all got to do. But I, you know, there's only so much I can handle at this point. And then the white girl was like, yeah, girl, I understand, honey. It is very interesting, like the little nuances and microaggressions that Insecure addresses, especially when it comes to black people in the workplace. And I guess this can also apply to black people in school as well, because the white girl that Issa is working with, she's just like, she asked the Latina teacher, like, oh, do we need some more cultural sensitivity? It's just like, okay, girl, you're trying, but if y'all got so much more to learn. So we see Molly ask her, and she's just getting her work done. She's just like, bitch, she's on a call or some shit. It sounds very important. And I was just like, okay, girlie. She was flipping through some mail and shit. She accidentally saw someone else's check. She thought it was hers. So yeah, that's how you know it's an accident, because she thought it was hers. She flipped that shit over and it said, Travis, girl. That check said an amount for $6,000, bitch. $6,000 bi-weekly, girl. I see why white males don't give a fuck about their life, bitch. They could just purchase a new one. $6,000 bi-weekly? Okay. All right. It's just so sickening how many issues and how many themes that Insecure brings up in a 30-minute episode. I can only imagine what she would be able to do with an hour, which I hope she gets in the future. But that just brings up the whole gender inequality when it comes to the fucking workplace and unequal pay, and also her as not only a woman, but a black woman. And it's just like, we want to see how Molly will go forth in addressing this situation, because she's not the only one to face that. And I'm sure that a lot of people watching this can relate to that. You know, she finds out that this man in the workplace, who does probably half the shit that she does, is getting paid that much more. So Issa Rae is just flipping through this motherfucking mail, honey, and she said, okay, girl, that's a bill. Okay, girl, that's junk mail. Okay, ooh, what's this, honey? What's this, honey? What's this, honey? Bitch, this is a juror summons, honey, and it is addressed to Lawrence ass, and she got excited because, like, bitch, you got to come get this shit. You got to come get this man, or else you gonna go to jail. I said, yes, ma'am, bitch. She was funny as hell, bitch. So I guess she thinks that's her way in, so she keeps that shit like it's a golden ticket. She keeps it like it's a get-out-of-jail-free card, like she was playing Monopoly, bitch. And she said, we gonna keep this shit moving. I'm gonna tell his ass, come get this shit. And my arm's gonna be wide open, trying to accept him back as my boyfriend. And, bitch, if I was Issa, my legs would be wide open too, honey. Lawrence Peen is immortal. Okay, so we see Issa and her insensitive ass co-workers, just racially insensitive as hell. All they ass is vindictive as hell. I can't even imagine being in that goddamn environment, bitch. I'm about to bust somebody in their motherfucking face. You know, the boss sees that We Got Y'all is flopping in the school that Issa was trying to reach out to. I forget the name of it. So she was like, girl, we might need to hang this shit up flat screen like Nicki Minaj say. But then Issa was just like, girl, you know, let me try this shit. You know, we can make some shit happen. You know, our jobs as educators not always gonna be easy. She did some blase, blase, blah shit, and the boss was just like, yes, girl, as somebody says, you can do it if you put your back into it. It really be funny, because in some interactions with white people, they'll do that, and they'll try to say, oh, what's the blackest thing that I know so that we can relate to each other? Okay, girl, sit your ass down. He's almost like, girl, you talking about Ice Cube? You can do it, put your back into it. So then Molly's drinking a little bit, not too much, because she's with her co-workers and with her firm. She sees the guy Travis, who got paid more than her, the check that she saw in the beginning of the episode, and she decides to go her ass on over there. They end up talking a little bit about pay and shit, about someone else being forced out. Molly was just like, maybe she didn't feel valued, and then Travis was just like, well, girl, you gotta speak up if you don't feel valued. You gotta speak up if there's something wrong in the workplace. You gotta speak up, girl. You gotta speak up, girl. It's like, okay, Travis, being loud works for your white male ass. A lot of times, especially as a woman, not only as a woman, as I said before, as a black fucking woman, when I open my mouth, I'm either too aggressive, I'm an angry black woman, or I'm not taken seriously. So it's like, what's the tea? What y'all want me to do? It's like, if I don't say shit, I lose. If I do say shit, I run the risk of also losing. And then still having to end up work there while I brought this shit up in front of my boss and shit. It is not as simple as that with your polo wearing, golf playing ass, okay? Country club built ass white boy. Move the fuck along somewhere. I guess Issa Rae is throwing a little wind down, cute little thing. It's supposed to be some cute, calm, and collected, you know, just four or five or six of the girls together in one, you know, one apartment. They're just gonna drink some wine, call her Rosie. I feel like my cheap ass has a big ass bottle of that shit in my fridge right now, okay? I'm not paying $200 for a bottle of wine. That's not me. That's not within my spirit. That's a whole bill. That's a whole Comcast bill, bitch. That's a whole motherfucking car note, bitch. I am not about to do it. So Issa was just gonna throw this shit and she said, you know what, bitch? I'm going to practice for when Lawrence is coming to get this juror duty. She said, you're gonna get this juror duty and here's your juror booty. But she said, I'm gonna bend down like this to get the motherfucking envelope on your ass so you can see what I'm working with. It was so funny to watch her over there trying to practice for when he comes over. It is so interesting because we've all done some dumb shit like that before when we had to get ourselves psyched up or ready to do something that is kind of intimidating or makes them nervous. So it's really interesting to see that shit on the screen. So the gag was, we're at this party, bitch, everybody's kikiing, and the doorbell rings, honey, and you know, we thought that it was gonna be Lawrence at the door, and it was, but girl, he's taking Tasha out. Yeah. The cinematography is excellent, by the way. Issa's brother comes into the party and he's just as gay as ever, and I live for everything that he's about. He came in to just read. As soon as he came in the room, he came reading, bitch. That's a queen, bitch. That's a queen, honey. And just like every queen, just like every queen, I'm sure that he's up to something crafty, and I can't wait. And I can't wait for the rest of the season to see what it is, bitch. I want to know who man he's sleeping with. I want something messy. I'm sorry. I know that the gay person that just came in, I'm already making him do something messy. But I'm sorry, girl. This just this one time, let him do something. Let him do one thing that's messy, like stereotypically messy, and then let him be non-problematic for the rest of the time. But girl, give me one good thing. Please, girl, please. So I like that the show plays all this relevant ass music. They was over here playing Cardi B. They were on the couch having a cute little conversation about, you know, their experiences as black women in the workplace. Then my girl Kelly came out here talking some dumb shit, talking about, ever seen locked up abroad? Bitch, they gonna lock up abroad. She went outside while Molly and Issa were having a conversation about Lawrence and how Issa lied and shit. We been knew that she wanted his ass back. Kelly came out there, started flirting with a bunch of hood niggas downstairs, bitch. Just my type. Hood niggas downstairs. I'm letting you know now. And she invited them up, girl, in a party that was supposed to be cute little wind down, you know, bun downs and high heels, legs crossed, type of tees. That's wind down turned into a turn up. Fuck a wind down, it's a turn up, okay? And I'm talking about smoking weed. Bitches was over here flirting. It seemed like Kelly was about to fuck on the couch with this one nigga. It turned into a whole mess. Bitch, then the garbage caught on fire. Now I said, oh girl, please don't start off an episode. Please don't start this shit off with a whole apartment burning down. I can't do it. I can't do it. I don't know if my soul will be ready for that shit. Issa lost her man. Issa don't know what the fuck going on with her job. And Issa gonna lose her apartment too. All in a day. Work, bitch. I said, please give my girl Issa a break, bitch. Issa gave herself a break because she wrote the show. She poured that shit on the motherfucker. She poured that water on that garbage. This shit was on fire, honey. All them hoes had left, bitch. Nobody would even stay to help her fucking put out the fire. Jesus, they all left, girl. You can see the real ones in your life because I think Molly and them were still there, right? You can see the real ones in your life, okay? When your shit is up in flames, are they gonna leave your ass? Or they gonna stay and help you? Are they gonna stay and help you through your hard time, bitch? I mean, we gonna move right the fuck along, but take that as you will. So Issa and that white girl, I forgot her name. Y'all gonna have to tell me her name in the comments. They were presented We Got Y'all Again at the same school because her boss let her do it again. And so they were waiting for the kids to come in, I guess after school, to get the resources to help their need. They need some tutors or whatever. So these kids came in and they're, you know, Issa was having like, oh girl, we can help y'all out. We asked for pamphlets and shit. Y'all probably didn't have those. This kid asked for help with geometry. Did the white girl said, girl, I know Latin and English, but I mean, that's about it. But I can help you out. I'm sure we can. So, you know, there was, you know, some progress was made. So after all that shit happened, after we thought we got a breakthrough, them hoes came in, they took their free food and ran, bitch. I'm talking about they took that free food, they took all that shit, bitch. I'm surprised they didn't take the poster, okay? They took all that shit and ran, and girl, that just serves as another failure. I don't know what they're gonna do with this. We got y'all, but do you have yourselves, okay? Get this shit on out the road, because it seems like it's about to be roadkill. And here comes Demon Lawrence. Here comes Lawrence demon ass finally to pick up his shit. His sure some is in mail and shit. And he came at the door looking like a whole fucking snack, a whole, I don't know what, I'm shaking right now thinking about the amount of dick that I'm missing out on simply because my ass is not Issa. You see what I'm saying? I need Lauren in me now. Okay, he came to the door. I said, girl, what's the tea? He came, got his shit. He said, oh, well, I got some shit in the bathroom. That's a number one fuck nigga trick, bitch. Don't be falling for that shit. But if he was fine as Lawrence, I would fall for that shit. I ain't like, don't fall for that shit, girl. If he asked to come in, girl, like that, girl, he could have said, go in there and bring it out. If he was gonna make you mail a whole jury summons to him, you gonna tell me that he wouldn't just go in there and ask you to take the shit out of the bathroom and give it to you? Girl, it's a trick. It's a trap, girl, and you fell for it, honey. You fell for it, and now he's dicking you down on a couch, bitch. Now he's dicking you down on a wine-stained couch, and you can't help but open your legs, because I would do the same thing, too. He dicked you down. He dicked you down on this couch. On the couch. On the couch he dicked you down, bitch. With his pants at his ankles. Ooh, it's a bunch, it's some niggas that did me like that, bitch. Oh, bitch. And girl, that's how I knew I couldn't fuck with they ass. That's how I knew it, bitch. They came over, they said, girl, I did what I have to do. And you liked that shit too, cause I heard your ass. So what's up, I'm done, I'll see you later. That's what Lauren said, he kissed on the cheek, I'll see you later. And then here comes my dumb ass sitting on the couch just like Issa, smiling and shit, giggling and shit. Bitch, no ma'am, no ma'am. That is not safe. He knows he has your heart. And not only does he have your heart, he has your pussy too, girl. That's a dangerous place to be in, girl. You need to reevaluate. You need to recoup. You need to have an emergency girls' night out right now. At this moment, drop everything that you're doing, girl. The demon Lawrence is coming, and he's coming with a vengeance, honey. I don't think he has your best interest at heart. I think he's still hurt about the fact that you hurt him first. So, girl, he's coming for your wig. He's coming for your wig. Did you hear what I'm saying? Bitch, he's coming for your wig, bitch. He's coming for it, bitch, and it's gonna be just like this. He gonna have it in his hand just like this, honey, in the next episode. So I cannot wait to see what the hell is about to happen. My pussy is shook, and so is yours after Lawrence done been all up and through there. Bitch, I would let him all up and through there. I want Lawrence all up and through there, bitch, okay? And I can't wait to see what's gonna happen next episode. Get your life, I'll be in formation next Sunday, bitch. You already know what the fuck the tea is, okay? Have a good goddamn evening. Issa, you better get your shit together.